There was a moment at the end of, I think it was, yeah, it was the end of season one. Mr. Capaldi was doing a take. We were, I'm not sure what episode it was, it might have been the last one. But the Queen, we were about to catch him out, and we were trying to sort of set this trap for him, you know, in a church. And the Queen was listening in, and he was kind of revealing the fact that he had all these plans and all this kind of stuff. So it was his take. We'd done myself and Aramis shot, and now we're turning around onto him. So we were doing the same sequence, but just from his, you know, from his perspective and from our point of view, if you like, but or from his point of view, but you know what I'm saying. There was a moment where Peter said he was kind of he was doing his thing, you know, and playing the scene, and he just suddenly switched and started swearing and being like, "You fucking knuckleheads!" You know, and he went crazy, and I got really like, you know, "Who the fuck are you talking to?" Kind of, you know what I mean, you know. I got really pissed at him straight away because I just thought, who does this guy think he is, you know, to try and talk to us like this? You know, we're actors, we're all telling a story, you know. And then effortlessly, he went into the speech. So he broke character seemingly and then went back into a speech. And I went, oh, he was using it to psych himself up. And he told me after that it was a technique they learned on the thick of it. But he went from being the cardinal to the worst Peter you can imagine, you know, saying that we weren't listening to him, you know, and it was all a ploy to get himself in character and to get himself upset. And then he went and he used it, and it just taught me a lot about how you get something for a shot. You know, there's a lot that happens behind and on side of the camera, you know, that sometimes is required for you to capture the essence of a moment or a motif. And just by, but you know, he completely convinced me. He convinced everyone on set. People were like, "What's happened to Peter?" You know, but he's just a great actor, you know. And so yeah, that was, you know, perhaps I haven't, well, no, I won't say that. It was a great moment. If I've expressed that, great. If you haven't got it, tough.
I've got to ask you,
Yeah.
100% sure
Yeah.
he was just getting your tape,
No,
wasn't really that?
he was, because I went up to him and I said to him, "Why did you direct that at me?" You know, and he went, "Because I knew that you would give me what I needed." You know, or so what words to that effect. He knew that I would believe him and react in that way, because again, my reaction to him, which was like one of, in this moment, I do not like you. Right? In that moment, sorry, you're right.
No, it's fine.
In that moment, right? He was then able, we call it the figure of eight, right? So in that moment, he was able to then look at me and get completely what he needed and look at me with the attitude that he needed as the cardinal, you know? Remember, this is a business of suspending one's disbelief, my own and yours. And so maybe Peter felt that he needed to believe himself more in the moment, whatever, but he needed to do whatever he needed to do to get in that moment. And as De Niro once said on the subject of one's process, it doesn't matter how you get there as long as you get there. If you don't get there, then we're going to have a problem. And he got himself there. He also got me there in that moment. So this is what we call genius, you know? So yeah.